All right, let me start out by thanking everyone for participating. I think this is important today that we have an opportunity to talk to our residents and guests of Beaufort County, the low country of South Carolina and Coastal Empire, just to kind of give you an update on what position that we feel that we're in, even though it changes maybe by the hour. So a lot of what we do is based on prediction. Let me start out by saying that we have been in continuous communication with all of our local partners as well as our state and federal agencies as it relates to the discussions of where we're at today and where we've been coming from for the last 24, 36 hours and where we possibly could be in the next 36 hours. A lot of it's a little iffy. This is kind of, I think the National Weather Service, Neil said it the best yesterday, is that storms such as this create their own weather, and we just have to kind of go along with it. I think the only person that's been through a Category 5 hurricane in this room is my good friend Dr. Rodriguez, and so he's probably got more experience than anyone in that area. And what we are seeing today in the form of news coming out of Florida is unbelievable. And I hope that everyone has been following that very, very closely to see exactly what I think it was almost a Cat 5, I think it was a few mile an hour short of a Cat 5, the devastation that it had on the coast of Florida and continues to create havoc as it travels through Florida and coming out into the Atlantic. Our county council chairman issued a state of emergency declaration on Wednesday the 28th, yesterday at 4 p.m. The state did their declaration at 3 o'clock, signed by the governor of South Carolina, and the municipalities followed suit and did theirs around 4 shortly thereafter. All of our county emergency services are ready, willing, and able to meet our residents and guest needs throughout the duration of the storm, and we're hoping that the duration of the storm is something that we can say will end hopefully Saturday morning. Then we can maybe start seeing a little sunshine maybe by Saturday afternoon. But until we get to that point, we still have some challenges ahead of us. I kind of want to recap a little bit just to kind of bring everybody up to expectation. A lot of people in this county remember Hurricane Matthew. A lot of people remember Hurricane Irma, 2016 and 2017. I just want to remind you that during Hurricane Matthew, we had one gust of wind of 86 miles an hour that was registered at the Hilton Head Airport. We had one gust of wind that was registered at the air station at 58 miles per hour. So keep that in the back of your mind, because I think everyone remembers what kind of tree damage, what kind of power line damage we had in Hurricane Matthew. And that's the gust of wind. Again, that was one gust at 86 and one gust in at air station at 58. Winds are predicted and potential that we could have winds on Friday through Friday evening, possibly between 58 and 73 miles per hour. And we could also see probably a Category 1 wind challenge, which is anything over 75 miles per hour, and that would be Friday through Friday evening at the worst point. Rain is expected. We've gotten several different numbers. I'm going to stick with 4 to 6 inches. We've heard 4 to 8 inches. We've heard possibly local in different areas as much as 12 inches. We've been fairly comfortable over the past week and a half of not having the inundation of rain that we had in the month of August and early September, so it's dried out a little bit, but we're still concerned with trees that are compromised, not only because of what we went through the month of August, but we still got some trees that are compromised since 2016. So when we start looking at the winds and the potential for wind, we look at how much rain could fall, not only coast, but inward as well. And then we look at the storm surge, which is similar to what we dealt with during Hurricane Irma, which is 4 to 6 feet. And that 4 to 6 feet is above dry ground. What normally is dry ground, you could see a surge of 4 to 6 feet above that. So, and that coupled with, you take the rain, you take the potential winds, and you look at the storm surge, and you look at our high tides, and if you just use a normal evolution of time, high tides will be either at midnight or midday today, Friday, and Saturday. So there's a lot of water that we're going to deal with. If we get the winds that we potentially could have, it's going to hold a low tide. It's going to hold a high tide going out. It doesn't appear that the tide ever went out. So all of that water is going to come back in a lot quicker. So we just want people to be very, very aware that that potential is there. And I'm going to touch on a couple of important things that I want people to try to remember over the next 36 hours. Let's get our errands run today. Let's try to do all the things that we need to do. If you need to go to the grocery store, go to Walmart, go to Home Depot, Lowe's, CVS, or any of the other outlets you need to go to, we need to try to get that done and try to get it done before nightfall. Because nightfall, we expect rain, we expect more wind, tropical storm force winds could be early evening with difficulty on that. Dealing with some potential water issues and what wind we'll have, we kind of need to get those errands run as soon as we can. Let's please refrain, and we'll send this out through not only a Nixle but some other possibilities. Let's please refrain from driving on any of our roads Friday and Friday evening. We prefer that you stay home tomorrow and throughout tomorrow evening. The less traffic we have out on these roads, the more opportunity that we can patrol the entire county. All of our law enforcement agencies are 24/7, our county EMS, fire and rescue on Hilton Head, Bluffton Fire, in all of our fire departments, we are at 100%. So we're out here. We'll be again, like I said earlier, ready, willing, and able to handle whatever the needs are. But if we can reduce the amount of traffic throughout the county, it would be a whole lot easier for us to do our job, and it's going to be a whole lot safer for you. I want to remind everyone as well, we talked about compromised trees, but when you're out and about tomorrow and tomorrow evening, even at home, you've got to be very, very cautious about being outside under trees, because with that wind and some of the water we'll have, you're going to have tree limbs that are going to be very, very dangerous, maybe tree issues, power line issues, and all the other things that we deal with. Stay indoors, again, if you can, Friday and Friday evening. And if we have flooding, which we expect in certain areas, please don't try to drive through floodwaters. Because you can't see what's underneath those floodwaters, and there may not be anything there. Just be very, very careful. So that's why we prefer that you kind of stay home and stay off the roads. Neil, you want to touch on anything that was developed today that you can add to?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Just a couple things. For those of you who are interested in OpCons, we are at OpCon 2, and we expect to stay that way. We will have the Emergency Operations Center on a limited activation starting at 6 o'clock this evening. Our law enforcement agencies, our fire departments, and EMS have appropriate augmentation of their staffing beginning this afternoon, this evening, through the rest of the storm. The sheriff just touched on not driving through the flooded roadways. If we experience the flooding that is being forecast, we would also encourage you not to walk through this water. This water picks up a lot of trash, a lot of nasty stuff that could very easily cause you some health problems in the future. So just stay out of it. The sheriff said stay home. That's the best thing to do. Stay indoors, ride this thing out, and then we'll deal with whatever happens afterwards. The shelter in Jasper County at the Jasper County High School on Gray's Highway in Ridgeland will be open at 5 o'clock this afternoon should anyone decide they would prefer to seek shelter away from Beaufort County, away from the waterways and the low-lying areas of Beaufort County. That shelter, again, will be open, and it is pet-friendly, and it will stay open through the duration of the event, and then we'll close it appropriately after the event's over with. That's pretty much what I need to touch on.
Okay. Mayor Porroll?
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. I think the county has done a great job to update the citizens, and what I'd like to add is the town of Port Royal is ready, and it has been very pleasurable to work with the county and the other municipalities during this, and the school board. The information that has been communicated back and forth has allowed us all to get prepared very early and to be ready for this storm, and we're ready to deal with things starting tomorrow and Saturday as they pass. Thank you.
Mayor Buford.
Yep. Thank you, Sheriff. Just want to reiterate a couple of things the sheriff said. Now's the time to be finishing your hurricane preparations, and we hope everybody will lay low after tonight and not be out on the roads on Friday. We're expecting similar flooding to what we had at Hurricane Irma. Just want to remind you, Carteret Street had over a foot of water. It didn't affect a lot of the businesses, but because people were out driving through that floodwater, it threw a wake and damaged a number of folks' businesses. So please be cognizant of what you're doing, you know, what your impacts do to others. From the City of Beaufort's perspective, our folks have been preparing for the last few days. Our Public Works crew were out this morning at 0400, making sure ponds were pumped down, ditches were clean. We removed the floats on our flap gates in Mossy Oaks. So I think we're in the best position that we can be, and our police, Public Works, and Fire Department will be standing by throughout the evening. But just want to say again, if you're out in the streets throughout this event and you get in trouble, you are putting other folks' lives at risk. You're putting our first responders' lives at risk unnecessarily. So please stay home. Please look out for one another. And I've been very impressed. This is my first hurricane as mayor, but been very impressed with Sheriff Tanner, Colonel Baxley, and the emergency management team. We're all coordinating on a regular basis, and I look forward to getting to the other side of this thing very soon. Thank you.
Mayor Slaw.
Thank you. Ditto. But I will ask all of you, especially in the Bluffton area, in and out of the town limits, you've seen the rain, as Sheriff said, about a month ago when where all the standing water was. Trust me, during Irma, you couldn't drive through the roadways, so add 6 inches higher. And Mayor Murray's right. In all joy, people thought it was funny riding down this and causing a wake, but what it did is cause major damage to homes that were already really threatened before the storm. So my prayers go to Florida. I am watching Sheriff. It's what we could live and will live one day, and we can't be in denial of that. So we have great staff. We have great relationships. We have great cooperation, and we'll get through this one. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Rodriguez.
Good afternoon, everyone. As you know, the Beaufort County School District is operating today and tomorrow as an e-learning day. That decision was made for several reasons. Obviously, the information and data coming in yesterday, as well as the information today that continuously evolves. Our buses simply cannot run on highway with high wind gusts or high sustained winds. And so we make those decisions in the interest of safety. The e-learning days provide some flexibility. It's not a decision we make lightly, but it is an important decision to make. And it offers our educators and students flexibility in that learning process. And so I want to thank our teachers, our administrators, our support staff, everyone within the school district who's worked hard to make these e-learning days a possibility. If utilities were to go out, one of the advantages of e-learning days is that there is that flexibility. Students received some work yesterday. They receive work today. So even if connectivity is not possible, that work is part of the instructional process for our children. And so that covers the e-learning days, saves the makeup days of December 20th and 21, which I'm sure nobody had any interest in. So again, thank you to our teachers, thank you to support staff, thank you to administrators, parents, and students for their engagement during these e-learning days. Thank you.
All right. Questions, if any? Tony?
Sure. If you have any expectation of an evacuation recommendation or order?
There is no evacuation order. I mean, that's as clean as I can answer. Yes, sir.
I know similarly, like down in Florida and stuff, you know, some of the third agencies will say, you know, you already mentioned stay off the roadways and we should, but are we at a situation where if the winds reach a certain amount that you say you can call 911, but they're not going to come out and because of the dangers for them? And secondly, after the storm, is there agencies already pre-staged such as power utility crews and stuff like that they can get right to work immediately restoring power after the storm has passed?
You know, I'm not one to retreat. The guys and gals at the sheriff's office and law enforcement throughout Beaufort County, we work in tough conditions all the time. I mean, this is something that we don't work in hurricanes every day, and we don't do it every week, thank goodness. But we work in tough conditions all the time, and we're not afraid of working in any kind of condition. So if someone needs our help in Beaufort County, we're going to do our very, very best to provide that help. And if we can figure out a way to do it, it's going to be done. We have some high water vehicles that we use throughout the county. I mean, the Bluffton and Beaufort and the sheriff's office, we all have high water vehicles. And if we can get to you, we're coming to you. Now, the difference in that is that, law enforcement drives, for the most part, low-profile vehicles. We also have access to the helicopter if the weather is available for it. We have boats. We have many ways to get around the county. But when we run into problems, is we run into problems with our ambulance service because those are top-heavy, very top-heavy vehicles. And they're a little more difficult to navigate, especially on open area, open terrain, especially causeways, bridges, and some of the other things. So we've got to be extremely careful with those. Fire trucks have a little easier because they're so heavy and the mobility is a little bit different, but the weight of a fire truck offers a whole different challenge as well. So we want people to use 911 or the non-emergency number. Give us as much information as they possibly can about any type of condition or situation they're dealing with, and we'll do our very, very best to get to you regardless of what the weather is. You know, we have to be careful. We can't be of help to anyone if we're injured ourselves in the process. So, we have to look at this case by case. Questions? Yes, ma'am.
Could you explain what you said OpCon 2 was, what that indicates?
Well, it's a readiness. It's for us to get all of our ducks in a row and make sure that we're all engaged and we are all communicating, and to make sure that if we go to another level, that we're ready to respond to that next level. So it kind of puts everybody on notice.
And that next level would be triggered when?
It really depends on what type of challenge we're getting from the storm. Now, our EOC will start up about 6. Right. Yeah, we'll start up about 6 tonight with a light crew, and that light crew is going to, we'll have DOT. Available, we'll have fire, EMS, and law enforcement, and county, what county department we're going to have? Public Works. So we'll have county public works. So it'll be a light thing. If we need to increase overnight, it's not a problem in doing so. If we see the storm is going to be more of a challenge hour by hour by hour, then we'll make those increases based on what we're looking at and what we're seeing. So we just, it's like the Weather Channel said, a storm creates its own weather, then we have to react to it. But I think in the National Weather Service, I mean, they do a wonderful job. It's an excellent job that they do. The predictions that they're making are very close to what the reality ends up being based on the storm. The scientific methods they use to calculate and predict, it's pretty good. So, and it's getting better as we move forward, and it really helps us a lot to try to predict and look at what the needs are could be for a county, a coastal county like Beaufort, and that way it gives us the opportunity to kind of plan ahead. But at the same time, we're planning ahead, we're having to plan for the moment, and that's kind of what we do. Any other questions for anyone else that's here? Lindsay.
Yes, sir.
This is where you come into play.
Yes, sir.
Okay, come on up here. All right. I really appreciate y'all making the trip today. And I know some of you came from, I think, from Savannah and other parts. I don't want to do that to you tomorrow if we don't need to. If we need to do another press function tomorrow, we'll do it. But there are other ways that we can accomplish this without having you drive all the way to Beaufort. Technology is great. We want to use it, and we want to use it to benefit everyone. But we do appreciate the information that all of you are sharing with our residents and guests, and it's extremely important that we do this. So if we get into a situation tomorrow, what other platforms do we have, and how can we share by doing a very small press release that everyone can get, if you can explain that?
Yes, sir. Well, of course, everybody can sign up for our Nixle alerts, and I know most of the media here is signed up for those. Also, you have the media releases that we send out. Facebook is a great way to find out what's happening with us, especially tomorrow as, you know, the storm progresses, and to where you can check out photos and video, etc. For you all, if we can reach back and forth, I can send you video, sound, you know, anything that you can utilize, so you don't have to make the trip and travel, and you can stay safe as well.
Okay, so. Thank you. All right. Any questions about any of that? When it comes to technology, I always go to somebody else. I think it's great. But County Channel, I mean, you've got a feed. You can share that with anyone at any time. So, I mean, there's always ways to do it. If y'all need anything at any time during the next, you know, couple of days or whenever, just let us know. Lindsay and Angela are always available. Angela's standing in the back. She's our PIO for the Sheriff's Office, and we can help in any way. But, again, thank you for helping us provide this information to our residents and guests. It's very important that they get as much information as they can, and we appreciate it. Thank you. There's no more questions. We'll bid farewell. Thank you.
All right, Mayor, good to see you. Talk to you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, we'll be on the 12th.
Where are you going to be?